So I went to a dealership and I got this power steering fluid kit. This is the cleaner that I'm gonna put in here. And so basically what you do is you put it in, you're gonna take these out first, take the old one out first, and put this in and start up the car and let it run for like, you know, 10 or 15 minutes. And while you let it run, just go in the car and just turn the steering wheel to the left and turn it to the right so it can circulate through the car and stuff like that. And after that, just drain it out and just top it off with this. So before, what they had was an ATF. You can see it, it's all red. Anyway, so I got this at Harbor Freight for pretty cheap. I'm gonna use this for second up. So you see that I got most of them out. Now I'm going to So now I'm going to go inside the car and just start it up and, you know, turn the steering wheel to the left and turn it all to the right. And just let it circulate. Been 15 minutes now, so now I'm ready to turn it off. Now I'm going to take the old fluid out. And now you use spray clean or whatever to clean it off if you want. So wait, I forgot. I'm supposed to do the pouching hose line too. I bought it for like probably 130. So what happened is, so this hose here intend to leak a lot. And it leaked from here and down here. So there's always fluid down here in this area. So a lot of people just cut up a hose from here to here and just put it in, but it doesn't last too long. It lasts only for years and leak again. So it's better just replace the whole thing. And it's running from here to down here, and it goes straight down here. So I'm gonna replace that today too. So I'm gonna start taking out this shield here. What we do is just push it down. It should pop up. You can take out this cover too, so you can see better. Pop this one out. Now what happened is you need a lot of space here to take the bottom hose off. So I'm going to start taking out this out and this bottom piece. But usually we don't have to take this piece out. But I think I might take this out so you see better. Try to remember what is what when you take it out. Like I said, you don't really need to take this out, but I'm just doing it so you see better. Now maybe I don't need to take these out. Maybe this should be okay. And if you worry about the engine dropping, it's not gonna drop. Let's put it back like that. Yeah, so I think I'm not going to guess I could take it out. It's just more space. Should be a big deal. Just leave everything there and just take it out. Now you can see you see that was leaking here. You see it? See all the leak in the bottom? So first, what I'm gonna do is gonna take these two out first. You also can put it back here, so it doesn't leak into the. You spin this around and grab it. Anyway, so you gonna be use one of the clamp on it. So to put that, so put this on the to the side, so you can reuse it. You look at this pipe here. If you go straight down here, this is a 10 you need to take out. So I'm gonna use this 10 and an extension to get it out. So this is the tin I took out. So if you're looking at the, this is where the power hose we took out. And if you go to, oh, it should be here, sorry. So remember, this is the piece we took out. And if you go to the bottom, as we hear that, this is the tank that I'm talking about that holding. Okay? So now we're going to go straight down and take out this other tank right here. So before I'm going to start taking out the tank, I'm going to, you see this one here? This is a little connector here I'm going to take out so you can move it to the side a little bit. And you're just going to pick. After you get it off, you can see that now it's loose now. The bottom, the AC line, not the AC line is loose. It's easier when it's loose so you can put in the new one. So the other tank I need to take out is right here. So you can push this out of the way now to get it easier. And this right here. That's the other tank. Just be here. And the last step is now is the bottom hose. We need to take out the clamp. So basically we're looking at a clamp now. So this part We made it ready, and we went down, and we got this tin off, right? And now what we're going to do is, we're going to take out this end of the piece in the car, the clamp, and after that, just pull it off. Or you can just take out this one and pull it off. Doesn't really matter, but you just need to take out this end now. And to do that, usually we can do it underneath the car. We can try to do it from this area. So from looking at here, seem like it's hard to do it up here. So I'm gonna go to the bottom and just take out the splash shield and just unhook the clamp from the bottom. But I'm not gonna do a video of that because it's too hard to record doing that. So I took out the bottom shoe. And that's the hose I was talking about. You need to take out that end, and after that, once you take it out, you can just pull it up from the top. So I got the bottom piece off ready, and you see that it's dripping a lot of fluid. Anyway, so you also have to reuse one of the clamp. So I'm gonna take it out and put it inside the other tube in this end. So when I put it in, I don't have to forget. So here come the fun part, taking it out and putting it back in. So when you take it out, you kind of play with it. Like you have to twist in a certain angle and stuff like that. Sometimes it gets clogged and some stuff, but it's, like I say, it's still doable. You just play with it. See? And so I got it out. The trick from putting it back in is this part. Make sure this part and this end and this end. I put some grease in it so it slide back and forth. So when you put in the angle, you can just turn it to a certain angle so it can go in easily. And for the new one, I'm going to take this clamp out. And just remember, this one is for the bottom. And this one is going to be the top. So, for the top, I'm going to take it out. And now I'm going to put this one on top, on the dash, I mean on the shock area. And when I take this one out, I'm going to put it in the bottom floor so I know this one goes to the bottom. Anyway, when you put it back in, make sure you push it in all the way until it hit the other nipple area here. And for the top, it's the same thing. Once you put it in, try to go to the end of this area and stop. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray some silicone in here. And silicone in here so it can move freely. I mean, it moves freely already, so it doesn't really matter. Except this one. This one's kind of hard to move. So I'm going to spray some in this one. Okay, so this one is easy to move now. So that was pretty easy. So now I'm going to tighten the tank that go here. What happened is, when you try to put this in and it doesn't stick in, you can put a piece of bubble gum or something and just put it in here so it won't drop. Like that. So what am I going to use is this little dum-dum they call. It's a little black sticky thing. Just stick on. And the bottom piece, I'm gonna do, now I'm gonna do the bottom piece. After that, you can see this connector was loose last time. I told you I took out the connector. Now I'm gonna put the connector back in. Okay, so it's good back in. Like I said, now we can do this part. So, yeah, forget this was this end. So I'm gonna put it in, it should hit the end of that. Then this end go this end. So that's good there. So now I'm gonna go do the bottom, and I'm not gonna do a video of that. So I got all the, I got the passion hose back on ready. Now I need to put back the mount. So I'm not gonna tighten everything down yet. I'm gonna just keep my hand first.
So now I'm gonna tighten everything back in.
So it's kind of hard to pour it in, so I'm going to pour in this pool first. So what happened now is I'm going to pour an extra one in here, because once you start up the car, it's going to drain down really fast. So I'm going to go start up the car now, and you will see it go down really fast. So now what we're going to do is just let it run for, 10, 15 minutes to let out the air bubble, and basically that's it for doing a fluid drain refill and a power clean hose run.